The newest trend to keep sex offenders from moving in next door, build a playground. That's exactly what the Bayberry Lake subdivision in Daytona Beach just did. They're hoping the new set of slides and monkey bars will ultimately keep the predators away. WESH 2's Amanda Ober joins us live from inside Bayberry Lakes. And Amanda, how's this going to work?
Well, Jim, first of all, I want to show you this playground. It actually is fairly small. It really is just some monkey bars and a couple of slides. But when you consider the residency restrictions on sex offenders and predators, they're not allowed to live near a playground, no matter how small, and residents are hoping this playground will keep them out of their neighborhood.
Oh, man.
Holly Pretty likes knowing that her 2-year-old daughter Mackenzie will be able to play outside without any fear of a sex offender living nearby.
That makes me feel good. I've only been here for a couple of weeks, and I was always concerned to take my daughter out in the public because I don't know what's going on in the neighborhood.
This small playground was recently built in the Bayberry Lake subdivision as a preemptive strike against sex offenders. The resident behind the project is Ryan Will, a prosecutor with the state attorney's office. Will grew concerned after learning a neighbor was being investigated for possible sex crimes. So he started researching ways to prevent sex offenders from moving to the neighborhood.
Before I did murder cases, I did sex offender cases, and I just knew that there were residency requirements. And so I started looking into how it is that you build a playground, what it takes, and what will happen once you have a playground established.
City laws bar sex offenders whose victims are younger than 16 from living within 2,500 feet of schools, parks, or playgrounds. Most of the homes in Bayberry Lakes were already covered thanks to an elementary school and a park. But there was a zone in the middle that was not covered, and that's where the playground was built. The majority of homeowners were in favor of it. Each had to pitch in a $100 assessment to help pay for it.
Sexual predators, you know, they need to be away from children, and that's it. I mean, the bottom line, you know, you don't need this in your area.
Now, the man behind this idea, Ryan Will, says as far as he knows, there are no other examples of this in other communities in the state of Florida, but he's hearing that this approach may catch on. Live in Volusia County, Amanda Ober, WESH 2 News.